there's that age where vana avanyari, and when they talk, ah, they don't want to go out, but yeah. And not daddy.
Mm-hmm.
And because I didn't have that father figure at home.
Mm.
So it was me and my mother and my sisters. Then we had I had a stepfather who stood in. But yes, obviously, he cannot be there 100%. Most of all financial issues or anything relating to me were a burden on my mother, right? And I remember when I was in grade 6, that's where my mother took me to meet my father, right?
Mm.
And because I was young, you know, there's an age where you can ask questions. If I was young, we got to where he was working, was now based in Harare. Oh, my daughter, how are you? He showered me with some money. So here and there, when I wanted money, I would just, you know, rock up at the workplace and I'd get money.
Mm.
That was grade 6, grade 7. After that, he was no longer at that retail chain store. I later then was told in form 2 that he passed on.
Mm.
In a conversation, he told Famba, like, South Yapere, I'm like, oh, okay. But I didn't know how to feel because of the absence of that relationship. That's form 2. So on my 18th birthday, my mother then told me the history, right? My mom, I won't lie, she was a strict mother. And she was like, you know what? When she was younger, she met my father. But obviously, my father was married and probably not even to her alone, because I then later met my sisters as I was growing.
Mm.
So my mother was like, when you know things happened, I fell pregnant. When I told him, auntie gave me money and said, go and get rid of it.
Mm.
But she did not. When she did not, she culturally kudara vainzi baba vangwasikanzi dedi. So my sekuru, her father, she told her mom, and her mom told the father, he had a routine every day. He comes back from work, watches news at 6 o'clock, comes back just before 8, watches news, sits supper and sleeps. But that day, by the time I come back, I want you gone. My mum was like, no, I'm not going to end. I told her, I'm like, don't worry. And Baba was like, I end here. She was like, Anna. Vakaita violence, mumba wakati nandi kubata buda muno. Vakapukanya dore mairara munu kuti. I said, go to the owner of your pregnancy. And she left.
How old was your mom?
She must have been 17, 16, 17, thereabout.
Mm-hmm. And dad was how old?
Way older.
Way older?
Yeah, because I've got sisters who are like way older than me.
Mm.
And then she left. That night when she left, she went to sleep at a friend's place with an excuse. But achi, kumuvi, ndanono kasa kanja kwanza kwenda kumba. But the following day, vakatanga kwenda nugara kuhama, kuti waenda kwa mainini. Her father would follow her there and say, enda kumuridzwe numbi yako. Kwese kwa vai enda, vainzi, enda kumuridzwe numbi yako. Kushika wazo enda kuna natano. That's the only place he could not make noise. But itano wakavu, watu threatena kunzi, munu wamaka chengeta huyu. Amusiri magampa numu, gavi pano. Vapeza kularo, vapatote atidisho kune sana nemi. Uyanga wandis kwa maivangu. Sano, after vayenda sano wakati kumuzuguru, mzuguru, kisa atidisho kune sana nemi kwa shawedu. Iva pano. So the whole course of her pregnancy with me, she was kumusha, kwa gogo, amaiva amai. That's the only place he could not go and remove her from there. And she says, it was a bad experience for her. Given Kuti, you know what, she thought Kuti, her father, you know, would understand. But Vangawari Baba, and you know, Kudara, Jainya, the second one, Okamitiswa. To a point where Pavakazo and Ekoko, in the Kazo Sharwa, Blawayo, she started staying with her Tete, then she moved to Harare. And I started learning, before I actually started learning, Vakan, they had a family tradition where they would go to their grandmother's side, Guababa, for Christmas.
So all this time, where's your dad? Does dad know?
He's not even anywhere in the picture.
But does he know that mom kept the baby?
Remember, there were no cell phones. I don't think he did. Or either if he did know, but antakapa munomari, and she didn't do anything.
So and she never tried to contact him during this time?
I wouldn't know now. But he wasn't there. Every burden was on her as the mother. And then when...
So masozra guapaya blawayo.
Tajarwa blawayo. Vazogera kumusha. Vazo no gara na tete kwa mtare. Vazo chakabasa ku... Vazo ya kwa harari. But family tradition, waenda kwa gogo. Then her father saw her. Vahati, urukita chipana pandaka kutichi. And he didn't want to see her. to a point where even on his deathbed, he had not forgiven her for me, for my pregnancy. Right. So when I look at it, it's emotional, the pain she went through as a mother. And that's why I love my son. Right. Being the only parent that's available now for Juju because his father is not around. I try to be a balanced parent. Make sure he knows both sides of the family.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. But Shaguti, nigata arudorwa baba. No. I do not know a father's love. Totozoana baba
bevamwe vanhu. Yeah. Let's go back na sekuru before. Because is it ashda unangana baba but sekuru baba bapinda munyaya.
True.
So sekuru vatsangwira mukunda wavo, it must have been disappointed.
True.
Disappointment. Mom tries to shield mwana wavo kati kuna kwaonenda baba kati papano. Singira mkunda wavo, kuzimba zavo, zainda mkunda wavo, sewa chinzi bako, ivako, mzukuru wo shakwa. Shokuro shika kumba utu mzukuru wavako, he still would not be a part of this.
True, and I actually never met him. I met him the time yarunzi vakaenda ku the family tradition, Christmas, what, but I was young. And we only then went to Bulawayo where he was staying, the time that he was now critically ill, right? That's when we went there.
And you saw him.
I never saw him. He was already hospitalized. So ndo kutotanga kutozoti ukundo kumba kwa gogo we kublawayo. Amai wanojara mai.
And your grandmother, where was she all this time?
She was there. She would frequently visit kumusha kwa mai vavoka. That's where my mother was. So her and the mom relationship was okay, but Baba was the one who was like, no,
yeah.
I will not have that.
Kutina ama adzipangwe sister's leave murimu no mkuru. Ama adzifani kupindele kuyana nisapakadai kana mwana arubushikoro wakaresha wakaitra pamuviri wakati ndia kune babe munu wakati atisikuita mwana anaika
yes.
Muri haifani kuya ere kuzoyana nisapakadai rupe kuti mwana adzokere mkwana na utu mwana it sounds as if mai vachiedza wakato zonge babe ngombe mdonjo upenyu watu chinja vakumusha baba vasikutombo ziva kuti mwana uripi urikuitei wakarorwa ere pamwe vangadai vakaenda kumukomana ye utovatambisa baba vasikuzviziva kuti mwana vari kuhama nana tete nana tsano hazadzamai nehazvanzidzana baba dziripi pakadai zvinoitika kudai.
There are a lot of dynamics that come with such situations.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, if this father was the eldest, no one can tonga him.
He was the second born.
Right. He was the second born. So already we can see where it's going. And who is the first?
It was another brother.
It's another brother.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So you would find we get the elder brothers. Or in the family, there is one brother or one tete. Baninge vachiti munhu wese, whether they are older than him or younger, they cannot voice against him.
True.
So that's one situation that we have in families. Yekuti, no matter how much they try, I will hit a brick wall. One. Number two, that person could be financial, is a financial muscle.
Mm.
And because they are depending on them, my supplies, they don't buy it.
Deplete.
You see. So those are some of the dynamics. And some of the issues is a personality issue where the personality of the person, no one can handle it.
But he was that baba, if and when he puts his foot down, what he says is what goes.
Yeah.
So,
does your mom have other siblings?
Yes, three.
Your mom and dad?
Yes. With her mom.
Pardon? You're sorry.
No, there's only me. With my father, there's only me. My mom and my father, there's only me.
Okay.
But I've got siblings.
All right. And your grandparents?
My grandparents had three other kids.
They had three other kids.
Although he had an outside kid as well.
The irony.
My grandfather.
And so your mother's siblings?
My mother was the firstborn.
She was the first.
True.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So when you grew up, did you sense that you were an unwanted child?
Somehow? Not even.
Not even?
No. Plus, you know what? Things only start to make sense. Wakura.
Mm-hmm.
So like when we went and we met him, when I was grade 6 years, hi. 9 grade 6 in Gabunze. But had I met him now, I could have asked, what happened? Plus, I was 18 years. Where I could now actually calculate and know. Because also, this is what happened. And to a greater extent, it answered some questions I had. My mother was strict and would beat.
Like, I think she's not my mother.
You see, but it's Jacques will make a sense, could okay, panenge paine an underlying effect.
Yes.
Of probably the trauma she went through,
mm-hmm.
the pain she went through, and wanting you to be a straight up child.
Mm.
You see?
Yeah.
Because apana mwa mbereka donyans wa mwana. Because it's never the mwana who nyaras, it's the parent.
So eventually dad, your dad knows that you exist. You go and see him. He seems happy to see you.
Yeah, like what was he gonna say? What could he have said to us to a grade six?
Yeah. So he did you then meet your because Mamuano Bavatkana Mwana
Awuya
Murino to Zvatumana Babuya.
No. So fast forward, after he died, I then was introduced to a woman. Ainzi is your auntie.
Mm-hmm.
So I started working for her. And then she went to tell her auntie, she assumed I was her brother's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
So when she told that Tete, kuti, nduku shandirwa nemwana wa ningi we hanzvadzi yedu. She can no ask mwana hanzvadzi yenyu, mwana wa baba venyu.
Ooh.
Which meant I was her sister.
Oh, wow.
When she came to work, the relation, how we were relating changed.
She wasn't happy.
She wasn't. So because now with growing up, meeting the other siblings. Now imagine, I used to work for a bus company. Wana Senem, because I then adopted Senem and Aseku. But in Dainzi, Senem and Babako, Ndeyakwakat. So imagine, I got a passenger manifest in Wana Senem. I'm waiting to see the person.
Mm.
I see them. I talk to them. What was So he had wives he married. And then he had other women he just had children with. Because he was top of a retail store where in every branch, in every town they were opening,
mm-hmm.
he was the one in the forefront. Mm-hmm. So there would either be a wife or there would be a girlfriend with a kid or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'm not mistaken, we are more than 20.
You've got that many siblings?
Yes.
Are you in touch with any of those siblings?
Some of them, because there's one particular sister from the brother, from my father's brother, who started a group, and she drew a family tree. Kuti, okay, our grandmother had four wives, and from those four wives, and the bulk of us who were not born from the marriage setup, we use our mother's surnames. Right? And ukatuona, one thing I'll tell you, most of us adopted our mother's beauties. By the way, my mother's very, very beautiful. Thank you very much for my looks. But we all have got the same hands and toes. Because the other girl, when I saw those chubby little fingers, I'm like, what? Then I'm like, Iwe, what do you wanna make one you? But you were quite angry. They got to know what? I got Buddha Manga to call a sister. I got this is our sister. And that's how I then started getting introduced to other sisters. So you're not depending on family to family. Mumanaga in the history on how their father was with them and left them. And their life went on.
Yeah. So if you could say something to your dad right now, Chetza, what would you say?
Honestly, with what I know, I think I was better off with my mother alone.
Yeah.
Imagine the rejection of a person you know is there.
Yeah.
It's like with what Tifa feels. Remember when we closed the show,
mm-hmm.
Kuti, you felt that love at some point. You've something to compare it to. I do not.
Do you feel rejected by dad?
I was okay. I felt like he did reject me, because how do you give someone money for an abortion? What's the meaning of that? They didn't want it. I did it. but then I am there. So obviously he could have chosen not to be part of it by virtue of saying, I told you to make a decision. I did what, that was your decision. Deal with it.
Yeah. So mom and dad's relationship, right? They clearly rekindled at some point.
Never.
What I mean is, at some point dad knew that you were there.
True.
But means mom and dad somehow were talking again.
True.
Do you have any idea what those conversations were like?
I would lie, sweetie. Grade 6.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I remember that day, Nakato had one in town. She was working when she was working. By lunchtime, we went upstairs to some office. We got there, and this is your father.
Mm.
That was it. So either there was any prior conversations made, even when I was there.
Yeah.
She was like, utter silence. Ah, Saka, you know the conversations you have with school children.
Yeah. Were you excited that this is my dad? Did you leave there with a sense of belonging after that conversation?
No, not really. With the money, yes.
which is a mistake that most fathers do.
True. Would you throw
it's
money?
Not the money that they want.
Mm.
It's the love from the father. I have a friend, they are not divorced. Get this right, they are not divorced, they are together, all is well.
Mm.
She went to the UK, left the family, the husband and the children here.
Mm.
So each time she would call, hi Mike, how are you? He would say, mommy, so when are you coming? He says, no, I'm not coming. So kufona ndiko kuya here mama.
You see.
Yeah, so what else do you want? What do you want me to buy? Mama saka
kuteka. As our fathers, as our uncles, you are Chiedza's dad. What goes on in your mind to a point where you know you have children? In his case, but when he found out that Chiedza is there, he still was not choosing Chiedza just like he was choosing his other kids. And still, it said he was still choosing which kids he wanted to take care of. How do you explain this as men to your daughter that's listening in to Chiedza 0719-100-404? Is it a case of our fathers, our men, just being deadbeat men? Or there's something else that we need to understand? You can clearly tell Chiedza, being a mother of her own now, is emotional about the issue.
Mm-hmm.
Grandfather also did not help the dynamic even more.
Mm-hmm.
How do you think we as women are moving around, you know, wanting and yearning that love from dad? We also have on the phone Sam. Sam, we had to reach out to Sam, you know, looking for a voice that understands, you know, childhood development, possible trauma that happens in our kids, to try and, you know, perhaps get Tifa help and also Chiedza to a place where, you know, the story is no longer painful, because it's still painful.
It is.
For a reason.
True.
Yeah.
As long as it's not addressed.
Yeah.
I mean unresolved issues, which might also get back to the fathers.
Mm.
Some of them are doing that because they've got unresolved issues in their lives.
Right. Right. Oh, we lost Sam. Maybe we just want to try to get a hold of Sam there. I said, oh, tibe try way papa, tibone sana o sana baba. Kuti pakadai, tine chishifambisa sei. Kuti vana vedu vatinao, vatakaita. Hatisi kumbovatsvakavo. Moya ugwadzi here uchizoti wakabereka asi mwana wako hausi kutombozoti ari kuita sei ari kudii muupenyu uchichengeta vamwe vana. Hatigwadziwiwo here tichiwa nyaya dzakadai dzinobva kune vanhu vakasiyana siyana vanakasiyana siyana vanoratidza chaizvo kuti nyaya idzi inyaya shuwa dzinochemedza dzinodawo a certain sense of closure and possibly even healing.
That's true. So you, whilst we were waiting for Sam to come through,
mm-hmm.
I spoke to one dad,
mm-hmm.
who left one family and mm-hmm. is staying with the other.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing that he made very clear is, I now have relationship issues,
mm-hmm.
because of the first family. He abandoned it, yes, but he feels bad about it. I think there's a combination of pride. There's a combination of that feeling of rejection and so forth,
mm-hmm.
that that's making him not to reach out,
mm-hmm.
to the family.
Mm-hmm.
So he says there was an issue of infidelity involved. So he felt, of the three children that they have, He's not sure. He says, only one that I can say is mine.
Mm-hmm.
But I really got put off by that. So I was asking, Tinana Tinashe Mugabe, now, who just says, come, let's confirm. I saw on Father's Day, I don't know whether it's true, if he's one who said, he said, happy Father's, happy alleged Father's Day. Until you come to me, then you're not yet a father, you're only an alleged father. All right, so we are saying, we were arguing, the shitty nini, why don't you verify and confirm whether these are your children or not, rather than just rejecting them? What will happen if you reject and then you realize they are your children? Then he says, no. So according to research, fathers, they get some of them, they've got new relationship what energy. It makes them forget the first family. Right. Others, they've got, now they can't strike a balance. The attention is divided, so they will concentrate on the new family and forget the old one. Like Chieza was highlighting, Kuchi, they would run after the father, kavawana mnyowani, banditi. Right. And also there are a lot of there are different dynamics that can come. The new relationship might offer comfort better than the first. So those dynamics or perceived better comfort.
Because the grass looks greener. Looks greener from their side.
Yeah.
And also they're trying to escape from past conflicts. And but, they don't want anything to do with anything that will remind them.
But these are your children. We understand the failed relationship with the mother.
Exactly.
But the children, why are the children having to be a part of this fight? Tumirai kamari kuvana, indai woku sports day, mungo timwanangu.
All those questions we try to discuss all of them. And he says, you know what? I know the moment I try to visit the child, I'll meet the mother. Then I said, but it's your child. He says, okay, with the dynamics that we have with this father now. He says, with the dynamics that we have, if I look at the child, I have one that I can look at and say, maybe in the language. But when I look at them, I think I might end up doing the worst.
I think men easily forget. It's easy actually for them to forget because they don't go through the trauma of pregnancy. For like you've never been pregnant before, have you?
No.
Mama uzivi kuti numbu ine naro.
Ine naro.
Unotanga unotaka kubata numbu, you're not sure with maybe you are or you are not. And then you might have morning sickness issues. I remember in my case when I fell pregnant, dairara shamari. Lights out. I liked spicy food, but black pepper yakataka kushata, curry yakataka kushata. The day ndakati yabika chafu no shata, then I thought, I need to check myself, and I did, and I was. And they came, they married, fair and fine. But imagine, uri pregnancy, uri one, usina support.
Yeah. And so how would you say your mom was coping with your dad being absent, would you say?
I wouldn't know, but I would like to believe she's a strong woman.
Mm-hmm.
For like there are situations where you are forced to grow.
True. No matter how
because worker. You have nowhere else to go.
Mm.
I consider her a very strong girl because we could have lost both Chieza and the mother. She would have just decided to go and hang herself.
Unazeroti numbu, it's not a way a mirror. Mama, you're not gonna crave me, you're not gonna morning sickness, I don't body. Zedu Zegazideva needs what? Ah, Musana Rosa, look at that pizza. Unega win a moon watch your goods. But I'm not gonna dollar after a pizza, ma'am.
All right, so we've got Sam back on the line. Before we meet Sam, you were also participating, you were also trying to ring us on 0719-104-04. We're trying to understand why a dad would possibly choose some of his children but abandon some other children. And now we're talking to the abandoned children and they're sharing their different experiences and clearly the pain that they felt. And we are trying to connect with you as dads, as our men, to help us understand. Do you feel ashamed at all by your actions? Are you aware of the emotional neglect you may be causing your children? But where do you place it all now that you are getting to meet what your child might sound like? She could be Tifa from last week.
Funaki. And then I'm in a similar predicament, isn't it? Funny, Mumuru Tilera, one side of the story. Do you know Wakazi, Mazumai Dwaya? Another use of an is weapon. Who punish one out? Someone one out. But there's a point in time you must run out to Mun, Arkur Creator. Timurume, Apira Gossi, I did Peter Gras. Although I admit there are womanizers out there and watching our cards, but in any, I've got two kids from two different women, but more one.
Yeah, thank you so much for bringing your side of the story. Unfortunately, the women we've met so far sharing their stories from Tifa last
broke up. She broke down. Mm. That's where she was going. That's what she wanted to explain.
Yeah, feeling as if dad is choosing. He's got the means, but he's blatantly choosing.
Yes.
To love other kids and others. You wanted to say something
and
about
you had.
Situation where only when the mother wanted money, they would avail the kid.
Uh-huh.
But he would go and time mira mwana kuchikoro.
Yeah.
Aizoti kumwanonga na zizaba chikoro chakati wanoklo kumuswa kata no peza. Onko mwona for 5 minutes. Uli say mwanangwe jokunzi baba maiva iti awo atidi mari yako atidi mari yako. Iyo shi wati vade mari yoyo would you not stop at nothing to go and see your kid?
Yeah. So we want you men to answer this question. Are you saying even when you've met a difficult woman who doesn't want you to access your children, because of a difficult woman, the law is also there to protect you. Help us make sense of this.
Like I said previously, I meet a lot of this situation. There are children who their fathers who come to see them at school. They come, they confide. Please, teachers out there, when parents come and confide, Baba Tireo and Iti, they come, they confide. You know what? We are not in good books with the mother. I need to be seeing the children. Okay, please, as you come to see the children, let's do it within the parameters of the law. Okay? You see them here at school where they're staying, they're staying with their mother. Okay? They come, they see the children, and they go. And we have rules that that would safeguard the children. But parents, the fathers, they can come and see their children, even at school. Come visit. We always get a consultation. The child says, I'd rather have, I can't have a perfect father out there in the monster at home.
Sam, please bear with us. I hope you're not growing whiter as you're holding on the line, listening into, you know, the different pain stories we have. We want you to come in a second, but we just decided to call this dad who sent us the audio note. Who was giving us, okay, I think we seem to have lost him. Okay, we're going to try to reach him. Sam, good morning. Thank you so much for listening in. We don't know what to do about women, some of our women, having grown up not having dads who are alive, but who simply made the decision or the choice to not be as available and as present as they are to their other children and are seeing this. We have Chietza, who was just giving us her ordeal. Dad was very clear to her mom to say, you are not having this baby, get rid of it. Now, from a somebody who deals with child trauma, how does this affect the well-being of a child, especially a girl child, growing up not having a dad present in your life?
Good morning, how are you?
Good, Sam. Thank you so much for being on our show.
I'm not sure if you can hear.
Yes, we are listening attentively.
Thank you. Yes, we are calling because of what you went through. And we are here to assist you.
Yeah.
But at the same time, healing is the process.
Yeah.
So when you go through this childhood trauma, what you need to focus on is the healing that you had if you go through different things in life. I just want to share with you maybe some of the ways that can of all is to validate or acknowledge the things and emotions that are associated with that personal abandonment.
Right.
And to validate the experiences.
Mm-hmm.
They also need to understand the feelings and the struggles that are common amongst like those we have experienced similar situations, maybe students from us as well. They will be opening up to what they have gone through. And also to exercise or promote to participate with this emotion of abandonment.
Yeah.
Normally, take this meeting on the wrong people, especially when you were traumatized, when you were.
Yeah. Sam, if you'd allow me to just ask you a question right there. What are some of the common emotional manifestations of children who were abandoned? If you can just give us one or two examples of the emotional and sometimes even the psychological effects of being left by dad.
Normally, it affects the behavioral changes that you might notice when most children were traumatized when they were young. For example, some will change to be introverted. Become so introverted that they don't want to speak or to see anyone.
Mm-hmm.
And some will become so emotional, like even a little reprimand, they will end up crying because of the emotional trauma they suffered when they were still.
Got you. And in terms of children,
doing things like eating, you will feel forgetting you will be able to do, but because of this other absence, the person may lack that.
Got you.
So you understand?
Yeah.
That's me.
Yeah.
So as much as maybe it can work for others, I can understand. I saw Taffy has got some of those traits. A bit reserved because Munu probably was exposed to the father, and then later the father came out of the picture. And then later...
a child who, and many people who have the space, right, where they don't think they have any pain or sense of abandonment about dad, especially if they never had a relationship with him. Unlike Tifa, where she, right.
Asked it yes, to a thing that she doesn't give all these other qualities. But some might also be like become outspoken because of what they went through. Because they are dealing with
things.
But what we normally maybe will not notice is that when you are outspoken, you are hearing out what is like when what is the situation that happens to you. Healing is the process.
I think I connect with what you're saying. Sorry, Sam, to cut you there. Because Chieta says she learned the story when she was 18.
Mm-hmm.
And she's carried this burden from her mom's burden to her grandfather dying without acknowledging that she is his granddaughter, to then hearing dad who met pleasantly, then died still. And, you know, she's carried this since she was 18. Although she's a mom, although she seems to be doing well, it's still a burden she seems to carry because she's still in pain about the story somewhat.
Only because we've spoken about it.
Yeah, but that's that still not you carrying the burden nonetheless? Even if it may not feel every day, but it's clearly something that's still in you, that's still affecting you.
Not entirely.
Also,
the other dynamic that comes with these children is they want to relate. Everyone is a father figure around, especially when they are the younger children. Someone is talking about, so I went to the park with my dad, we had pizza with my dad, we had this. You know, it gives a different perspective altogether,
yeah.
Right? So every child would want to have a father figure present.
Mm. All right. So we're trying to call that our dad again, who, you know, sent us this audio note. Sam, please don't go anywhere. You're so useful to us and we are learning. We're all processing ourselves because a lot of times I think we're carrying things and yes. We think we're okay, right? We think we're okay. But when you talk about them, then you see that you're not okay. I think that's a sign in itself that this is still something that you need to process, even though you are confident, even though you have it figured out, you have a loving man, but somewhere this issue is still alive.
You know what we do when we do counseling?
Mm-hmm.
When you want to join the counseling team,
mm-hmm.
we'll ask you to pour out, tell us everything that might affect you, that might make you break down.
Mm-hmm.
Even things that happened when you are 2 years that you remember.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't pour out and if you don't cry about it, then it means we may not have successful counseling from you.
Mm.
So I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Trauma is situated in Shevarungu, because now that's what called trauma.
Yeah.
You know, the trauma, shall you pick yourself up and you go.
And this is such an important question that you're asking, mm-hmm. Chieta, because many of us have endured very difficult things in our lives.
Please,
and we've accepted that it's normal. Izvana trauma is even pashkaranga atina ibwira kuti trauma. So Sam, maybe you can speak to that before we bring in our dad who sent us an audio note. Our dad, just hold the line a second. Speak to that, Sam, this idea of, you know, izvana trauma is this not a foreign concept to us? Nekuti tinochengetwa nevamwe vanhu, like Chiedza is saying, she was raised still by other people who stood in place of dad who was absent.
Okay, just want to answer the question that was being said with the context when they were saying that the trauma is something trying to put a
mm-hmm.
But you find out that in our Shona environment,
mm-hmm.
Sometimes behaviors that see people who display, we tend to because maybe we don't know how to deal with that issue of being traumatized.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, most people, those are ads and this is because the earning identity Manhattan tree. I'm sure I could move you, maybe after that activity. This decision is really made me think, but because you have that Torah, like you could see, Una made the trauma, Una made the thing that you need to, like, pull yourself up and touch nothing because you are
thinking. Yeah.
But we think, like, this season that we are in, that the instrumental of have been talked about everywhere.
Yeah.
Awareness going on. So at the same time, maybe it will need it's like one to look in the air.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. See or we can get.
Yeah. Sam, if you could just give us your number quickly, because we're going to be crossing over to Dad, but then also news is just around the corner. How do we get a hold of you if we are people who have trauma and need help dealing with it? If you can give us your number quickly.
0789-669-859.
Thank you so much, Sam. Dad, you're on the line. You sent us an audio note where you're explaining that you are one such dad where you are no longer taking care of your children. Nekuti mai ndovaipwa. Isachibvunza namuno kuti shuwa shuwa sababa. Mabva mashaiwa here zvira yekuti vana venyu munokwanisa kuvaona zvachose chose here kuchikoro munogona kuva kunovaona pa break time nepa home time paya. Shuwa shuwa mazano abva apera here ekuti vana tivaone tivachengete.
I think I have to correct you, and that is, I was one such dad, and that is teacher. Because now, when I see the same way, I know how to tell you that it is Vana vatatu vaone.
Eh.
Eh, primary yako nevo vatatu tamwa vana vatiye me janaka akanganisira. Like in my instance.
Yeah. So until now. Yeah. So I can show you how to have a choice. Nanas.
Now my eldest is in form 4 right now. Okay. My mother is cooking barum form 1.
Okay. Okay. How did you then resolve this? Makazo wana say access kuwana wachu.
I am in the throat a much time, then I have no plan. That's when the
talk
with me.
Yeah.
Now.
All right. Only because of news, we're going to have to leave the conversation here. It's 12 o'clock. It is time for the news.